Hey everybody, what's going on? I'm Seth. If you don't know me, I'm running Frontline Access right now, and I just wanted to give an update on our fundraisers. First of all, though, I want to tell you again, and I know I've said this before, but I really mean it, how just humbled, grateful, and appreciative I am of all of you who have supported the project. Because this is a crowdfunded project right now, none of what we're doing. None of what we're doing would really be possible without your support and your really generous donations and contributions to the project. So, the last couple of weeks have been kind of a revelation, and I just want you all to know how truly appreciative, humbled, and grateful I am from the bottom of my heart. So, thank you so much for that. I wanted to give an update on how we're spending the funds. Like I said, I would. I'm not going to itemize those here on the video, but they will be itemized in the text below the video. We spent a little over $800 so far out of our just under $1,200 that we've raised on the GoFundMe. So that leaves about $350, a little more than that, in our funds. There are some things immediately that I would like to use those funds for, but I'm holding off to make sure that we have enough for travel expenses if I need to get back down to Portland or elsewhere right now. Some of the things that the additional funding would go to is more. I need a couple of software items for not only my computer, but possibly for the video editor's computer that is volunteering his time for us, and we're having possibly somebody else come on to help at the back end, the website and the techie stuff on the website. So I need to get some stuff for him. Also, we're looking at just like a branded hat and like t-shirt and clothing, and not to sell, just like a couple of those so I can wear in the field to let everybody know who we are when we're out there. Brand awareness, obviously, but also I've run into a couple of situations where I've gotten pushback because people see me out there in, no logoed clothing or anything like that, and they're like, "Who are you? Are you really here?" I've handled those pretty well. I mean, I've, 18 years in the biz, you know how to handle those situations, but it would certainly help just to have like, Frontline Access here on a t-shirt or something like that so they actually know. So, also travel expenses to try to get outside the Seattle area is needed. But look, we've got enough to keep this going right now, but I just wanted to give you an update. But we are going to need, and this is odd for me because I've never had a project where I crowdsourced or fundraised at all. So this is always a little awkward for me, but we are looking for more donations and contributions as we continue to get this up and running. Obviously, if you can contribute more, if you are able to contribute either through the GoFundMe here or any of the other platforms where we're fundraising, we'd really appreciate that as we continue to build this thing from the ground up. So if you are able to contribute again, we certainly appreciate it. But even if you're not, just your support and your eyeballs on the channel means so much to me. And I'm not trying to like beat a dead horse here, but I think about the gratefulness that I have quite often over the last couple of weeks to all of you. So again, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. There's an update. I've got a lot of work to do, so I want to get back to it today, but I wanted to get that update out. Thanks so much. And if you're not liking the Frontline Access page, you better do that, right? We also have a Twitter account. We're just setting up a YouTube today also. So like all of our platforms, be sure you help share and get the word out about our coverage. And I guess we'll talk to you later today or soon.